Hey guys, got this hot water heater here. It needs some new elements out. Anyway, now I'm gonna go shut the power off to the water heater. Okay, the next step is to turn the water off. This is the incoming water. Okay, before I get too far with this effort, I already got my hose hooked up, but I wanna make sure, I got the breaker off, but I wanna make sure there's in fact no power. No power to this. So now I'm hooked up here. I'm gonna go run the other end outside. All right, now we're gonna go ahead and drain it. Now you can hear the water flowing through it. Okay, so just to kind of show you, still got cold water. To the hot, nothing. Just a triple check before I go touching these things with my screwdriver. That off, set it aside. That off, set it aside. Okay, I noticed it's taking quite a while to drain it. So I'm just gonna open this, kind of let some air into the system. Hopefully it'll maybe go quicker. And I'm gonna go ahead and flip the relief valve. All right, so I don't have a 1-inch socket or a socket to fit this. So what I do is I have two crescent wrenches. I took this crescent wrench just like this. You're kind of using it how you're not supposed to use it, but this is all I got. So you push that in like that, and then I took a second crescent wrench and put it over this. Okay. Yeah, so I'm pushing this way with the crescent wrench. I'm taking this other one. Going around right here, so pushing real hard. I'm just using this as my lever right here, and I'm able to turn the element with that. As you can hear, still draining. Here's the lower one, so I'm gonna do the same thing. Okay, well, I'm waiting for that to drain. Here's the one I bought. Got these from Lowe's. These were 19 bucks a piece. 4,500 watt, 240 volt. All right, I'm ready to pull this top one here. So I'm gonna go ahead and pull this out of the package. And then I can slip the new one in once I pull that one off. Okay, I've already kind of loosened this with that two crescent wrench method. And so I'm gonna go ahead and just use the one on here for now. Get it to where I can loosen it with just by hand without the wrench getting close. Okay, I got the new one ready to go. I'm just gonna slap it in there. Ready? Here we go, the old one's coming out. Actually, hold on one sec. I'm gonna take a towel and kind of tuck it in here a little bit to protect everything. You take it, tuck it in there with a screwdriver. And that way it'll catch some of the water coming out of there. New one's ready to go. All right, we're rolling. There we go, there goes the new one. Plug the hole. idea here is just to crank it down enough so it doesn't leak. I'm not giving it my all, but making it nice and snug. Now we'll go ahead and hook the wires back up, so it doesn't matter which way you hook these up, because as long as electricity flows through it, it doesn't matter. So I just slide that in there nice and tight, just like that. I'll crank that down. Same with this one. Crank it down. There we go. Okay, there we go. So I'm just going to make sure all the water is dried up all around there. The bottom one is the same way. So these things get installed the same way you remove them. The only thing that took me a minute was I had to get this gasket off there. I hurried up and shoved that other one in there. Well, I noticed the old gasket was still in there. Well, that's not going to work. I don't want an old gasket in there. So I had to pull it back out again and then and put the new one in. And the new one comes with the gasket. So I didn't want any too much gasket in there. So anyway, that's how it's done. And I'll just replace the cover here and then put the insulation back down, put the cover back over it. I'm going to turn the water back on, the relief valve back off, and then turn the power on.